Welcome to Talent Connected Worldwide, a CICC authorized immigration company. We live in a world where borders seem less like barriers and more like starting lines, right? People are always looking for a fresh start, a chance to rewrite their story. And when it comes to picking a new chapter, two countries consistently top the charts, Australia and Canada. Why? Well, both countries have this rep for being super welcoming to immigrants. They're like the cool kids in the global cafeteria, always down to make space at the table. Plus, they've got stunning land backs from the outback to the Rockies. And let's be real, who wouldn't want a side of epic scenery with a life upgrade? But choosing between these two awesome options, that's like picking between Beyonce and Rihanna. Both are queens, but they both bring different vibes. And let's break it down, shall we? We're about to dive deep into the whole Australia versus Canada debate, comparing everything from education and job prospects to the cost of living and how to make your stay permanent. Stick around because by the end of this, you'll be ready to pack your bags and say good day world or bonjour to le monde to a whole new adventure. Alright knowledge seekers, let's talk education. Australia and Canada both boast world-class education systems. We are talking institutions that'll make your brain do backflips, in a good way of course. Down under you have got giants like the University of Sydney, known for its sandstone buildings that look like straight out of Hogwarts. Meanwhile, Canada throws some serious academic heavyweights into the ring like the University of Toronto and McGill University, which are basically the Harvard and Yale of the North. But here's the catch, studying abroad ain't cheap. Thankfully, both countries get it. They offer a buffet of scholarships and financial aid options to help ease the financial burden. Plus, they understand that sometimes you gotta hustle while you study, right? That's why they allow international students to work part-time. It's all about the work-life-study balance, am I right? And once you have rocked your studies, both countries offer post-study work visas. This means you can stick around after graduation and get some sweet, sweet work experience. Think of it as an extended graduation party but with more resumes and job interviews. Okay, so you have aced your studies, maybe even landed a sweet gig. Now you're thinking, I could get used to this whole maple syrup and Tim Tams lifestyle. But how do you turn that temporary visa into a permanent address? Canada rolls with the express entry system. It's like speed dating for skilled workers. You create a profile, rack up points based on your age, education, work experience, language skills, and other factors. Then, the Canadian government plays matchmaker, inviting the highest-ranking peeps to apply for permanent residency. It's all very organized and efficient, just like the Canadian themselves. Australia, on the other hand, prefers points based on factors like your skills, English proficiency, and work experience. But it's less about racing against the clock and more about showcasing your long-term potential. Section 4. Jobs, jobs, jobs. From outback adventures to Toronto's corporate towers, let's be honest folks, bills don't pay themselves. So what about job opportunities in these two lands of opportunity? Australia is booming in sectors like mining, healthcare and technology. Think of it as a land of sunshine and six-figure salaries. Well, for some professionals at least. They're always on the lookout for skilled professionals. So if you've got the chops, Australia might just roll out the red carpet for you. Canada, meanwhile, is a haven for tech wizards, healthcare heroes and finance gurus. Toronto's financial district is basically Wall Street's cooler, more multicultural cousin, and cities like Vancouver and Montreal are teeming with startups and tech giants. No matter which country you choose, remember, networking is key. So polish up those LinkedIn profiles, people. Section 5. The price of paradise. Big city lights versus small town charms. Now, let's talk about the cost of living because nobody wants to end up living in a shoebox, even if it's a shoebox with a view of the Harbour Bridge or the CN Tower. As a general rule of thumb, both Australia and Canada can be a bit pricey, especially in the big cities like Sydney, Melbourne, Toronto and Vancouver. Think rent that could make your eyes water and avocado toast that costs as much as a small car payment. But here's the silver lining. Smaller cities and regional areas in both countries offer a more affordable lifestyle. So if you're willing to trade skyscrapers for stunning natural landscapes, you can definitely stretch your dollar further. Plus, don't forget about the universal healthcare both countries offer. That's right, free healthcare. It's like a warm hug from the government when you're feeling under the weather. Section 6. So, where to plant your flag? Alright, let's recap, shall we? Australia pros: sunny weather, year-round laid-back lifestyle, strong economy, diverse job market. Cons: high cost of living, especially in big cities, distance from other continents, hello jet lag. Canada pros: welcoming and multicultural society, universal healthcare, strong economy, close proximity to the US. Cons: long cold winters, unless you are into that sort of thing, high cost of living in major city.
Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, hit that like button and subscribe for more.